subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't send a letter through the post. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the best of creation to you. Inna arsalnaka shahidan wa mubashshiran wa nadhira wa da'iyan ila Allah bi'iznihi wa sirajan munira. He sent the best of creation to you. He sent the most beloved person to him, the most beloved and most dearest person to him. He sent none other than our Prophet Muhammad salawatullahi wa salamuhu alayhi, the very person that even the likes of Musa, that even the likes of Isa salawatullahi alayhi pray, O Allah, make us from amongst his ummah. O Allah, make us from amongst those that receive this invitation from him. This is who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent to your door. This is who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent knocking on my door. And the invitation wasn't on a piece of card from mouth to the mouth in gold lettering. The invitation was in the form of a miracle. A miracle yesterday, a miracle today. It will remain a miracle till the day of judgment. The invitation was in the form of a Quran, the book that caused a revolution in every corner of the world. And this is what the invitation read. Inni anallah, la ilaha illa ana fa'budni. O Musliman, O insan, I am the Almighty Allah. There is no God worthy of worship but I. O insan, I am the King of all kings. O insan, I invite you. Akimi salata li zikri, akimi salata li duluki sham. Inna salata kalat ala al-mu'minina kitabun mawkuta. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu sta'inu bis sabri wa salat. O insan, I the King of all kings invite you. I invite you to my palace. I invite you to my gathering. I invite you to come and spend time with me 5 times a day. I invite you, come and converse with me. Come and speak with me in qiyam. Come and speak with me in ruku. Come and speak with me in prostration. Come and speak with me in tashahud. O insan, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنْسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. This was why I created you, so that you spend your time with me. كُلُّ نَفْسٍ ذَائِقَةُ الْمَوْتِ. And remember, this gathering will not be for a long while. This is a very short gathering. And when this gathering comes to an end, just like every other gathering, just like tonight, there will be a dawah. After that gathering, there will be a dawah. And that dawah will not take place in some petty palace. It will take place in a place bigger, in a place billions of times bigger than this earth, which amazes you, in a place labinatun min zahab wa labinatun min fidda wa malatuha al-misk al-asfar wa hasa'uha al-lu' wal-yaqut wa turbatuha al-za'faran. In a place made out of bricks of gold and silver, there will be a brick of gold, and there will be a brick of silver, and then there will be a brick of gold, and then there will be a brick of silver, a brick of gold, a brick of silver. And these bricks of gold and silver will not be joined together with a mixture made out of sand and cement. These bricks of gold and silver will be joined together with a mixture made out of musk, with a mixture made out of emerald, ruby, diamond, you name it. This will be the mixture. Hatta إِذَا جَاءُوهَا فُتِيَتْ أَبْوَابُهَا وَقَالَ لَهُمْ خَزَنَتُهَا سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ طِبْتُمْ فَادْخُلُوهَا خَالِدِينَ. And the doors of this palace will already be open for you. They will be welcoming you. Babu Rayyan will be open. Babu Jihad will be open. Babu Salah will be open. Babu Zakat will be open. Babu Sadaqah will be open. And just like any other palace, when you enter, there are wardens waiting for you to escort you inside, to take off your coat. There will be wardens waiting for you. The doors are open, and as soon as they see your blessed faces, they will say, Salamu alaykum, enter the gardens of delight to dwell therein. And then the setting of this invitation, Allahu Akbar, fi sidrin makhdood, wa talhin mandood, wa zillin mandood, wa ma'in maskood, wa faakihatin kathira, la maktu'atin wa la mamlu'a, wa rishin marfu'a. This is the setting of this invitation, fi sidrin makhdood. There will be thornless oak trees, and there will be banana trees, and there will be apple trees, and there will be guava trees. Allahu Akbar, it is mango season, there will be mango trees, and there will be melons, and you name it, they will be there. And these fruits, there will not be one or two. These fruits will be a part of one top of another. The bananas will be piled on top of one another. The apples will be piled on top of one another. The pears will be piled on top of one another. The grains will be piled on one another. Wama'i masfuq, and there will be shade with the mountain extended, and there will be water flowing, and there will be so much food, fruit in plenty, and there will be raised couches, and just like any other dawah. And then the scenery, Allahu Akbar, fiha anharu min ma'in ghayri aqil, wa anharu min labanin lam yataghayyar ta'mu, wa anharu min khamri lazzatin lish-sharibin, wa anharu min athri mutaffa. The scenery of this invitation, you will see rivers of water which is not polluted. You will see rivers of milk whereof the flavor has not changed. You will see rivers of wine which is delicious for the drinkers. You will see rivers of honey which is pure. This will be the setting, this will be the scenery of this invitation. And just like any big gathering, and just like in any other palace, there be entertainment, there be singing women, there be dancing women for your entertainment. There will be huri'een, so beautiful that I don't even have to walk up to describe these beauties. Why? Inna أَنْشَأْنَاهُنَّ إِنْشَاءً وَجَعَلْنَاهُنَّ أَبْكَارًا. Because they are a new creation. They have never seen before. They have never been touched before. They have never been tasted before. إِذَا أَعْرَضَ عَنْهَا إِعْرَاضَةً إِزْدَادَتْ فِي عَيْنِهَا سَبْعِينَ ضِعْفًا. So beautiful, so beautiful. When you take your face away from her, she will become 70 times more beautiful in your eyes. This is their beauty. So sweet. لو أن عورا بسطت في سبعد أبحر لأذبت البحار من عذوبة فمها. That if she was to spit in the ocean, the salty water of the seven oceans will become more sweeter than honey. This is for your entertainment. This is the entertainment. What's the state of this entertainment? My words cannot describe their beauty. And then to serve you, just like in any other dawah, you have servants to serve you. The servants to serve you, they will have so much nur on their faces. They will have so much light on their faces that thinking that they are angels, you will begin to prostrate before them. You will begin to make sajda before them. Allahu Akbar, the dastarkhan of Jannah will be laid. The ma'idatul khuld will be laid. Just one corner of the dastarkhan of Jannah will be bigger than this world. It will be bigger than the east and west. وَيَقْطَعْ إِلَيْهِ بِسَبْعِينَ صَحْفًا مِنْ ذَهَبٍ لَيْسَ فِيهَا صَحْفًا مِنْ لَوْنِ أُخْتِهَا يَجِدُ لَذَّةَ آخِرِهَا كَمَا يَجِدُ لَذَّةَ أَوَّلِهَا. And these servants will come. The servants will come. They will have trays of gold. And these trays of gold will contain such blessings and such food. كَمَا لَا عَيْنٌ رَأَتْ وَلَا أُذُنٌ سَمِعَتْ وَلَا خَطَرَ عَلَى قَلْبِ بَشَرٍ. No human eye has ever seen such blessings. They have not crossed the mind of any human being. No ear has ever heard with regard to these blessings. This is the food that will be in these straits. It will make you forget the biryanis of this world. It will make you forget the bhajiyas and samosas of this world. This is the entertainment. And while you are eating and you have eaten, now the entertainer, the Almighty Allah, the inviter, will reveal himself to you. The words will be flowing on your lips at the time. Rabbi, arini wajhak nanzur ilay. Rabbi, arini wajhak nanzur ilay. Oh Allah, oh Allah, reveal yourself. Oh Allah, show us your beautiful face. The Almighty Allah will reveal himself. The Almighty Allah will show himself to you. And there will be so much nur, so much light will descend upon you. Had the Almighty Allah not decreed that you do not burn, you would have certainly, had the Almighty Allah not decreed that you do not burn, you would have certainly burned. This was the invitation that you received. This was the invitation that I received. This was the invitation that we all received. The invitation was from the Lord of the heaven and the earth, from the Lord of the earth and kursi. The invite was in the form of the Quran. The messenger was none other than our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What's the state of this invitation? What's the state of the host? What's the state of the invite? What's the state of the inviter? You received this. You received this from no king. You received this from the Lord of the heaven and the earth. From the Lord of the heaven and the earth. And you received this directly. I ask you today, O Musliman wa Jamaat, how did you respond when you received this invitation? What was your reaction when Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when you received the Quran of Rasulullah, when you received the Hadith of Rasulullah, when Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the message came to your door, I ask you today, what was your reaction and how did you respond to this message? I will tell you what our reaction was and how we responded, how twofold the words are. إِمَنْ يَحْدِهِ اللَّهِ فَلَا مُضِلَّ لَهِ وَمَنْ يُضْلِلُهُ فَلَا هَادِيَ اللَّهِ. Whoever Allah guides cannot be led astray, and whoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala leads astray cannot be guided. This was our reaction. This is the way we responded. Never mind thanking the Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Never mind falling in sajda there and then, thanking the Almighty Allah. Never mind being overwhelmed with happiness. Never mind prostrating before the Almighty Allah in shukr. Never mind thanking Allah for guiding us. Never mind thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for choosing us. Never mind thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for inviting us. Mind my words, but we could even give a monkey, we could even give a talk, we could even care less with regards to Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We couldn't even care less with regards to the Quran. We couldn't even care less with regards to the Almighty Allah. Never mind it exciting us. Never mind it exciting us that we were the chosen ones. Out of the billions, Allah chose you. Out of the billions, Allah chose me. We were untouched. We didn't even raise an eyebrow. The empty masajid at the time of Fajr, the empty masajid at the time of Zuhr, the empty masajid at the time of Asr, Maghrib, Isha. These weeping masajid, these masajid that are shedding tears are living proof that we rejected this invitation of Allah, that we rejected standing before the Almighty Allah, standing before the Almighty Allah. Our outward appearance, the earrings in our ears, the gold rings on our fingers, the chains on our neck, the wedges on our head, the clothes on our bodies are living proof that we rejected this invitation. Our social conduct, our behavior, our day-to-day living, our rioting and breaking people's property and then drinking the liquor ourselves, na'udhu billah, is a living proof that we rejected this invitation of the Almighty Allah. The Quran covered in dust in our clothes is a living proof that never mind reading the Quran, never mind holding the Quran, We didn't even bother to look at it. We didn't even bother to read it, to realize our purpose in creation, to realize why the Almighty Allah has gave us wujud, why the Almighty Allah has given us existence. We gave more time to the junk mail that comes through our door than we gave to the Quran. We gave more time to the tabloid script in one day than we gave to the Quran in our entire life. We were more interested in the blessings of this world. We were more interested in the jackals and wackles and the shaitan and what the shaitan had to offer than we were with the Almighty Allah, the Lord of the heaven and the earth, and what Allah had to offer. Na'udhu billah, one whisper from the shaitan. There is a banger tomorrow in Leeds. There is a banger in Manchester. Be it day or night, we won't even look whether it's raining or snowing. We won't even look whether it's cold out there. We won't even look whether that gale force wings. We won't even look whether it's hundreds the miles away. We won't even look whether we've got an important appointment tomorrow or not. We won't even look whether it costs hundreds of pounds. Na'udhu billah, one whisper from the shaitan, there's a bangla tomorrow. You will see, na'udhu billah, you will see obedience in our intention. You will see obedience in our preparation. You will see obedience in our action. This, we are ready to become the slaves of the shaitan. We are ready to serve the shaitan. Look how Allah, how beautiful Allah invites us with the sweet words. The Almighty Allah invites us. Hayya ala salah, O Musliman, come to my gathering. Hayya al-Fulah, O Musliman, come to success. This is the way of the Almighty Allah invites us. I ask, when we know that this invitation is incomparable, when we know that the post is unique and untouchable, when we know that the reward is immensable and undescribable, then why is there this rejection? Why is there this disobedience? And why is there this neglect? When we know that this invitation is incomparable, and we know that this force is unique and untouchable, the Almighty Allah, and when we know that this reward is indescribable, then I ask, why is there this neglect? Why is there this refusal? And why is there this disobedience? Do you not realize that you and I are the only ones in the entire universe? You and I are the only ones in the entire universe that refuse to accept this invitation of the Almighty Allah. That you and I are the only ones that refuse to prostrate before the Master. That you and I are the only ones that refuse to glorify the Master. He invites the heaven and the earth, a creation billions times bigger than you and I. The heavens and the earth, a creation million times bigger than you and I, they reply, O Allah, we will come willingly, O Muslimat. There is not, do you not realize, there is not a single thing within the heaven and the earth that doesn't prostrate before the Almighty Allah? Do you not realize, there is not a single thing within the heavens and the earth that doesn't glorify the Almighty Allah? Open the book of Allah, woman be his. The seven heavens glorify the Almighty Allah. The earth glorifies the Almighty Allah. And those within the heavens and the earth glorify the Almighty Allah to such an extent that our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, مَا فِيهِ مَوْزِيُ أَرْضَ أَصَابِ إِلَّا وَعَلَيْهَ مَلَكٌ صَادِرٌ, that you will not find the space of four fingers on the heavens. You will not find the space of four fingers on the heavens except that you will find an angel of Allah, a malaika, in prostration, prostrating before the Almighty Allah, worshipping the Almighty Allah. Or in thoughts, you will find four fingers like this on the heavens except that an angel prostrating. Yet you and I, we find it too much to lower ourselves. We found it too much to bow down. We find it too much to allocate 5 minutes of our time, 5 times a day, for the Almighty Allah. Directly above the heavens, directly above the Kaaba, in the seventh heaven, is the house of Allah, the Bayt al-Ma'mur. 70,000 angels make the walk around the house of Allah, and they will keep on doing so right to the day of judgment. After these 70,000 angels, there are billions of angels waiting for their turn, and as soon as they get their turn, they will go around this house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yet you and I, we find it too much to glorify the Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Inna lillahi azza wa jal malaika, the Almighty Allah's angels, from the day Allah created the heavens and the earth, these angels went into prostration. At this moment in time, as I address you, these angels are prostrating in the heavens. لَمْ يَرْفَعُوا رُؤُوسَهُمْ وَلَا يَرْفَعُونَهَا إِلَى يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ, and these angels have never raised their heads, and they will never raise their heads right to the day of judgment. There are angels of Allah from the the day Allah created the heavens and the earth, these angels went into ruku. As I address you at this moment in time, these angels are in ruku. لَمْ يَرْفَعُوا رُؤُوسَهُمْ وَلَا يَرْفَعُونَ إِلَى يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ. They have never raised their head, and they will never raise their head right till the day of judgment. There are millions of lives. In each life, there are millions of angels. Their right hands are over their left hands, and they are standing in their rows, and they have never come out of their rows, and they will never come out of their rows right till the day of judgment. Inspire these angels that are glorifying the Almighty Allah, these angels that are across the nation, these angels that are in ruku, these angels that are in qiyam, these angels that are in tashahhud, on the day of judgment, they will say to the Almighty Allah, Subhanak ma abadnaka hatta ibadatik. O Allah, we have not worshipped you in the manner we should have worshipped you. O Allah, we have not prostrated in the manner we should have prostrated. O Allah, we did not bow down in the manner we should have bowed down. O Allah, we have not performed ruku in the manner we should have performed ruku. Yet you and I find it too much to prostrate before the Almighty Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, around the earth of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created these angels, they made dua around the earth of Allah, and they will keep on doing so right from the day of judgment, and they glorify Allah with the tasbih, subhuhun, subhuhun, subhuhun. There are angels of Allah that glorify Allah with the tasbih, subhanallah aliyyud dayyan, subhanallah shadeedul anta. There are angels of Allah that glorify Allah with the tasbih, subhanaka wa bihamdik, ala hilmika ba'da ilmik, subhanaka wa bihamdik, ala afwika ba'da qudratik. Even the sun, which is million times bigger than you and I, recognizes the greatness of Allah, recognizes who the master is, recognizes who the Lord of the heaven and the earth is, and the sun prostrates before the Almighty Allah every morning and every evening. Yet you and I are absolute nobody, but we cannot find 5 minutes, and we cannot allocate 5 minutes for the Almighty Allah five times a day. There is not a single thing that doesn't prostrate before him. Even the stones are no exception, and they glorify the Almighty Allah. Sayyidina Yunus alayhi salam is in the stomach of the fish. It is the darkness of the night, in the darkness of the ocean. When this fish gets near to the seabed, there Sayyidina Yunus alayhi salam can hear the pebbles and the stones that are upon the seabed glorifying the Almighty Allah. That is when his Yunus calls out, La ilaha illa anta subhanak inni kuntu min al-zalimin. There is not a single thing that doesn't prostrate before the Almighty Allah. If there is somebody that doesn't prostrate within the entire universe, it is you and I. When najmu wa shadru yasjudan, from the stars to the trees, they prostrate. Even the animals are no exception. Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal relates a hadith in his Musnad in Kitab al-Zuhud, that Sayyidina Dawood alayhi salam, he makes his way to the seashore and he stands before the Almighty Allah in prayer. A frog goes up, Ya Dawood, innaka haddatta nafsak, innaka tadabbahta fi sa'atin, laysa yadhkurullaha fi ghayruk. O Dawood, a quran just crossed your mind that you have glorified Allah at a time when nobody else has. Get rid of this quote from your mind, because here I am a frog. We are among 70,000 frogs, so we are all glorifying the absolute master. There is not a single thing that doesn't glorify the Almighty Allah. Allama Alusi relates in his tafsir, and when Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam is receiving revelation, he begins to think about his family at home. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala orders, O Musa, with a stick in your hand, strike this great rock. Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam strikes this great rock. He strikes the great rock. The rock cracks into two. Inside this great rock is another rock. He strikes the second rock. The second rock cracks into two. Inside the second rock is a third rock. He strikes the third rock. The third rock cracks into two. Right in the middle, in the darkness of the third rock, is a maggot-type worm with food in its mouth, and it is glorifying the Almighty Allah. Subhana man yarani wa yasma kalami wa ya'rifu makani wa yadhkuruni wa la yansani. Glorified is the one who knows where I am. Glorified is the one who sees where I am. Glorified is the one who hears me. Glorified is the one who remembers me and does not forget me. How truthful the Quran is. وَإِن مِّن شَيْءٍ إِلَّا يُصَبِّحُ بِحَمْدِهِ وَلَٰكِن لَّا تَفْقَهُونَ تَسْبِيحَهُمْ. There is not a single thing that doesn't glorify the Almighty Allah. That is a different thing that you and I do not understand, the way these things glorify the Almighty Allah. There is not a single thing that doesn't prostrate before the Almighty Allah. That is a different thing that you and I do not understand, that the way these things prostrate before the Almighty Allah. From the birds in the heaven to the fish in the ocean, from the creepy crawling in the earth to the animals in the jungle, there is not a single thing that doesn't glorify Allah. If there's something that doesn't glorify the Almighty Allah, if there is anyone that doesn't bow down before him, is there anyone that doesn't prostrate before him, it is such to say that this someone is none other than you. I ask, يا أيها الإنسان ما غرك بربك الكريم. What makes you care, your careless with regards to your Lord? And what makes you so ungrateful? And I ask, what makes you and I so selfish? هل أتى على الإنسان حين من الدهر لم يكن شيء مذكورا. Oh my Muslim brother, do you not recognize that Allah and Allah alone was the one who honored you and I? We were nothing. We were not even worthy of mention. We didn't even exist. Allah was the one that gave us wujud. Allah was the one that gave us existence. And He didn't give us wujud and existence when Kalimah Kun did come into being. And we came into being like many of his other creations. When it came to your turn, when it came to my turn, the Almighty Allah decided to create you with His very own hand. He created you with His very own hand. This is the honor that He gave you. He gave you such superiority that He ordered the angels to prostrate before our father, Sayyidina Adam alayhi salam. The angels recognized this superiority and they replied to the Almighty Allah, Subhanak, la ilma lana illa ma allamtana, innaka antal alimul hakeem. The trees realized this superiority, the oceans and animals realized this superiority and became subservient to man. Then Allah didn't leave this just to that. The Almighty Allah announced our superiority in the miracles of all miracles. وَلَكَدْ كَرَّمْنَا بَنِي آدَمَ لَكَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ بِأَحْسَنِ تَقْوِيمٍ. O Musliman, that are very sitting here, the Almighty Allah said that I created you, I created the insan in the best of status, in the best of form. Allah gave us all this, yet you and I, we refuse from prostrating before the Almighty Allah. We refuse from bowing down before the Almighty Allah. Then look at the perfection the Almighty Allah created you with. Open the books of Allah. ثُمَّ خَلَقْنَا النُّطْفَةَ عَلَقًا فَخَلَقْنَا الْعَلَقَ مُضْغَةً فَخَلَقْنَا الْمُضْغَةَ عِظَامًا فَكَسَوْنَا الْعِظَامَ لَحْمًا ثُمَّ أَنْشَأْنَاهُ خَلْقًا آخَرَ فَتَبَارَكَ اللَّهُ أَحْسَنُ الْخَالِقِينَ. تَخْلُقُكُمْ فِي بُطُونِ أُمَّهَاتِكُمْ خَلْقًا مِنْ بَعْدِ خَلْقٍ فِي ظُلُمَاتٍ ثَلَاثٍ. Look at the way the Almighty Allah created you in the wombs of your mother in three veils of darkness. Not one, not two, three veils of darkness in the wombs of your mother. Look at the way Allah created you, creation after creation. Look at the way He changed a sticky white substance in mixture with the worst blood. How He changed it into a clot of red blood. Then how He changed this clot of red blood into a flesh. And how He separated the flesh into hands, into feet, into ears, into nose, into mouth, into tongue, into the digestive system, into lungs, into heart, into liver, into kidney. Then the Almighty Allah gave all these organs a function. The eyes to see, the ears to hear, the nose to smell, the mouth to eat with, the tongue to taste, the hands to touch, the feet to walk with, the heart to circulate the blood, the stomach to digest. The stomach to digest the food. And then you were so special in the eyes of the Almighty Allah that the Almighty Allah gave you your special identity. You were so special that He made you so special that He gave you your special identity. Thus we find every fingerprint is different. Thus we find every earprint is different. Well, my brother, you have no value for this. You don't even, because you don't even consider these things a blessing. You don't even consider these things ni'mat. Tell me, قُلْ رَأَيْتُمْ إِنْ أَخَذَ اللَّهُ سَمْعَكُمْ وَأَبْصَارَكُمْ وَخَتَمَ عَلَى قلوبكم من إله غير الله يأتيكم به. Tell me here and now, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was to take away His blessing, was to take away His ni'mat, was to take away the nur of your eyes, was to take away your eyesight, now you will realize the value of this blessing. You will realize the value of this blessing. And all of a sudden, there is total darkness. There is darkness to the front of you. There is darkness to the right. There is darkness to the left. There is darkness to behind you. In one second from a totally independent person, you have become totally dependent. Never mind making it to your houses, to your comfy bed. You won't even be able to leave this bed, and all of a sudden the sweat will begin to fall from your body. And if this nur could be purchased at $1 billion, and you possess this $1 billion, you will sacrifice this $1 billion for this nur. Have you realized now that the value of this blessing? Yet you still deny the blessings of the Almighty Allah, and you refuse from prostrating before the Almighty Allah. Tell me, if here and now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was to take away His blessing and you lost control of your bladder, here and now drops of urine began to come out one after the other, my brothers, your face will become so small, your face will drop in humiliation because of the drops that are coming out, and you will begin to think, how am I going to leave this thing? I hope nobody finds out. In humiliation, now have you realized the blessing of the Almighty Allah? He created you in perfection, yet you still deny the blessings of Allah, and you refuse from recognizing Him as your master. You refuse to recognize Him as your creator. You refuse as acknowledging Him as the Lord of the universe, the Lord of the earth and kursi. My brother, then in the wombs of your mother, when nothing could get to you in three worlds of darkness, Allah was the one that provided for you. He was the one that changed that blood to become your food. Then He brings you into this world. You were so special that He creates the world before you, and He plans and He put everything in position just so that you can come. Open the book of Allah. أَلَمْ نَجْعَلِ الْأَرْضَ مِهَادًا وَالْجِبَالَ أَوْتَادًا وَقَرَفْنَاكُمْ أَزْوَاجًا وَجَعَلْنَا نَوْمَكُمْ سُبَاتًا. Didn't Allah make this earth a bed for you? أَلَمْ نَجْعَلِ الْأَرْضَ مِهَادًا وَالْجِبَالَ أَوْتَادًا. And did he not make the mountains as a bed so that the earth doesn't tilt? وَقَرَفْنَاكُمْ أَزْوَاجًا. And did he not make create you in bed, male and female, so that you can get up with your sleep, a thing of rest? You can keep on reading the book, the verses of Allah with regard to the blessing, yet you still deny the blessings of Allah. Look at your side, you are nothing with regard to the creation that He's created. But you were so special that He subjected creation that are a million times bigger than you. He subjected this creation to you, to be of service to you. Open the book of Allah. وَسَخَّرَ لَكُمُ الْفُلْكَ لِتَجْرِيَ فِي الْبَحْرِ بِأَمْرِهِ وَسَخَّرَ لَكُمُ الْأَنْهَارَ وَسَخَّرَ لَكُمُ الشَّمْسَ وَالْقَمَرَ دَائِبَيْنِ وَسَخَّرَ لَكُمُ اللَّيْلَ وَالنَّهَارَ. Open the book of Allah and keep on reading. وَالْأَنْهَارَ خَلَقَهَا لَكُمْ فِيهَا دِفْءٌ وَمَنَافِعُ وَمِنْهَا تَأْكُلُونَ وَلَكُمْ فِيهَا جَمَالٌ حِينَ تُرِيحُونَ وَحِينَ تَسْرَحُونَ وَتَحْمِلُ أَثْقَالَكُمْ. Keep on reading these verses till you finish the ruku. Open the book of Allah in a different place and you will see the blessing. وَاللَّهُ جَعَلَ لَكُمْ مِنْ بُيُوتِكُمْ سَكَنًا وَجَعَلَ لَكُمْ مِنْ جُلُودِ الْأَنْعَامِ بُيُوتًا تَسْتَخِفُّونَهَا يَوْمَ ظَعْنِكُمْ وَيَوْمَ إِقَامَتِكُمْ وَمِنْ أَكْوَابِهَا وَأَوْبَارِهَا وَأَجْهَارِهَا أَثَاثًا وَمَتَاعًا إِلَى حِينٍ. وَاللَّهُ جَعَلَ لَكُمْ مِمَّا خَلَقَ ظِلَالًا وَجَعَلَ لَكُمْ مِنَ الْجِبَالِ أَكْنَانًا وَجَعَلَ لَكُمْ سَرَابِيلَ تَقِيكُمْ الْحَرَّ وَسَرَابِيلَ تَقِيكُمْ بَأْسَكُمْ. Open the book of Allah from another place and you will find the word. نُسْقِيكُمْ مِمَّا فِي بُطُونِهِ مِنْ بَيْنِ فَرْثٍ وَدَمٍ لَبَنًا خَالِصًا صَائِغًا لِلشَّارِبِينَ وَمِنْ ثَمَرَاتِ النَّخِيلِ وَالْأَعْنَابِ تَتَّخِذُونَ مِنْهُ سَكَرًا وَرِزْقًا حَسَنًا. All this, yet you are so big that you refuse from prostrating before the absolute master. Open the book of Allah. أَمَّنْ يَهْدِيكُمْ فِي ظُلُمَاتِ الْبَرِّ وَالْبَحْرِ أَمَّنْ يُجِيبُ الْمُضْطَرَّ إِذَا دَعَاهُ. Isn't Allah the one who responds to you when you are distressed? Is He not the one that removes the evils and calamities? Was He not the one that made you inheritors of the earth? Is He not the one that guides you in the darkness of the land and sea? Even better, He was the one that made you a Muslim. He was the one that chose you. He was the one that showed you the path of both Him for you. Whom He favored, Sirat al-Ladina al-Amta alayhim. He was the one that taught you to become the ummah of our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Just sum it all in two words. وَمَا بِكُم مِّن نِعْمَةٍ فَمِنَ اللَّهِ. Everything came from the Almighty Allah. Every single thing, every blessing that if you spend your entire life counting the blessings of Allah, your life will come to an end. But the blessings of the Almighty Allah will never come to an end. And this is how you repay these blessings. That this is how you show gratitude that you don't even have 5 minutes to spare 5 times a day before the Almighty Allah. Yet when your friend calls and he rings and he knocks on your door and you are eating food, you will leave the kebab and you will leave your food and you will go with your friend and you will not be bothered. Yet you will not be bothered. You will not be bothered. You will go with your friend. When one person does just one favor to you, you will hold this person in high esteem. You will bow down before him. You will respect and honor him. Yet the Almighty Allah, He invites you, Hayya ala salah. He invites you, Hayya ala salah. He invites you to serve him. He invites you to become his slave. And yet, at the time of Fajr, you give priority to your own bed. At the time of Maghrib, you give priority to your work. At the time of Asr, Maghrib, Isha, you give priority to the TV. You give priority to the shaitan. You give priority to the football matches and you refuse to prostrate before the Almighty Allah. We refuse to prostrate before the Almighty Allah. Why do we not hold Allah in high esteem? Do we fail to recognize our master? Do we fail to recognize his splendor, his power, his might, his purity and mercy? I came to convey just one message. Unfortunately, I haven't been able to finish up what I said. Nobody's able to finish up what I said. But the message that I came to convey today was, last year, it was the right of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And this year, it was the right of the Almighty Allah. Recognize who the Master is by recognizing his attributes. Recognizing his power, his mercy, his purity, his might, his splendor, his glory. And then recognize who you are. And then recognize that He's created you for one reason and one reason only. He's created you so that you become a slave, so that you prostrate and you bow down before Him. You bow down before the Almighty Allah. And if we, in each and every one of us, go home today with this message and we act upon this message, then I think that I have done my job. But if this is not the case, then I failed. Allah gives me the tawfiq to ask upon what I said. Allah gives me the tawfiq to ask upon what I said. Thank you.
لا تقل هم قسى في الفؤاد قد رسى إنما العزم طبيب للأسى هاجر الحزن وراح وطوى ليل الجراح إن آمالي كإشراق الصباح ثم آخيت الرجال أهل صدق واعتدال